Daddy.
Oh, hey, baby. Oh, I see you got the paper already.
Yeah.
Let me get the sports section. Was it in the bushes as usual?
As usual.
Mm-hmm. Well, I see you dressed for the day. Where you going?
I'm running some errands. Then I'm going by to see a friend of mine.
That friend wouldn't happen to be Brian, would it?
Yes. What's wrong with me seeing somebody, Daddy?
Wouldn't be nothing wrong with you seeing somebody if that somebody was worth seeing.
And what's wrong with Brian?
Baby, what ain't wrong right with Brian? I mean, he ain't got a job. He almost 40 years old. Gonna be time to retire in a minute, and he ain't even started working yet.
Daddy, he does have a job. He's been there for almost a year now.
Well, if he been working for a year, why he still asking you for money?
How you know that?
Baby, I've been around, and trust me, you ain't the only one he got giving him money either. Y'all leave him alone.
He is not like that, Daddy.
Mm.
Good morning, folks.
Hey, son.
What's up, Mom?
Good morning. How you doing, Grandpa?
Oh, watch it there, son. Oh, Lord have mercy.
Daddy, what's wrong with your shoulder?
It's just my arthritis acting up again. I'll be all right.
Have you been for your yearly physical?
It ain't time yet, I don't think.
I think it is time.
Mm.
Especially if you're that sensitive to touch now, don't you?
All right, I'll call Monday morning.
No, I think you call today. And right now, please.
Okay, you say so.
Oh, thank you.
Lord have mercy.
Excuse me, Mama. Sorry, Grandpa in there giving you flack about Brian. Well, you know he's right, don't you?
Now, I don't need you in my business, too, okay? I'm a grown woman and I can handle my own business. Thank you very much.
Well, from the looks of what I seen, you can't be handling your business too well.
And what is that supposed to mean? What did you see?
Well, you know that fly little honey dip that works down at the grocery store in the fruit section?
The produce section, boy.
Yeah, whatever.
Yeah, what about her?
Well, the other day I caught him in there squeezing on her melons.
Oh, that ain't nothing. He probably was trying to make sure they was fresh, that's all.
Nah, I ain't talking about the ones in the store. I'm talking about them big melons she got on her chest. I can't, they kind of just...
Boy, I don't believe you.
You don't believe me?
No.
You can believe what you want. I've seen it. But he ain't seen me, though.
And when'd you see this, Terrell? When you was out past your curfew?
Nah. This was earlier. But speaking of this whole curfew situation, we need to talk. Look, Mom, I'm almost 18 almost. I'm 17 right now. I'm almost grown.
Damn.
And I just feel I'm too old for curfews and all that other kiddie stuff. I mean, none of my homies got curfews.
Your homies ain't mine. You are. And I say, you get in here at 10 o'clock p.m. on the weekdays and 12 a.m. on the weekends.
Wait. 12 o'clock, Mama? 12 o'clock, the party's just starting.
Well, your party just ending at 12. Anything you need to do, you need to get it done before 12 o'clock. What you can't get done before 12 o'clock, you don't need to be involved in anyway. It ain't nothing good going on out in them streets after 12 midnight.
Mm-hmm. It's a couple things. I done did after 12.
You know what, Terrell? I done told you. What you do in the dark gonna come to the light. Just because I don't see it don't mean it won't catch up to you. And I don't have to see it in order to know, because I will know sooner or later. Don't that little girlfriend of yours have a curfew?
Nah, she can come and go as she pleases.
I
her mom worked like two jobs, so ain't nobody ever home.
Mm.
What makes you think I'm kicking her anyway?
You need to slow down. And since your little girlfriend can come and go as she please, she need to come over here and go to church with us sometimes. And you better put your hand down unless you want to lose it. On another thing, you are on punishment.
For what?
For thinking you can come up in this house when you get ready. That's for what?
Grandpa, can you talk to your daughter? Tell him too old for punishments and all that other curfews.
That's between you and your mama. I ain't in there.
Grandpa. Daddy, where you going?
Oh, the doctor's office was closed, so the nurse on the phone told me to come on down to the emergency room. They gonna give me something for my pain.
You in that much pain?
Just a little bit, baby, but I'm gonna be fine now.
Whoa. I'll go with you. Matter of fact, I'll drive.
Well, you come on then.
Terrell, you are not to leave this house until I return. When I get back, I'll discuss the rest of your punishment.
Yeah, whatever. Hey, man, moms be bugging. But I ain't crippling, though. I know what I'm finna do. I know exactly what I'm about to do. Hello? What's up, baby? How you doing? Oh, that's good. That's good. Who, me? Eating some cereal. You know how I do. Well, let me ask you something, though. Where your mom at? Oh, she not, huh? So don't you say I come holler at you for a minute? Yeah? All right. I'm on my way. All right. Woo! About to go see my girl. I'll be back. Hopefully I get back before anybody knows. And ain't nobody gonna find out. Ah. Need some clothes and I'm out.
Here, Daddy, she's yours.
Oh, thank you, baby.
This boy.
Them pain pills starting to kick in, sweetheart. I'm gonna go lay down for a little while.
Okay, you call me if you need something.
All right, baby.
Terrell! Terrell! Terrell Eugene Miller!
Huh?
Boy, why I gotta call your whole name before you answer me?
I didn't hear you.
What'd your grandpa tell you about wearing that hat in the house?
I'm sorry, mother.
You keep on, you gonna see.
So what they say about grandpa, Ma?
Took some tests, ran some x-rays, and did some exams, and they said his prostate is enlarged.
What?
But they won't know anything until all the results come back.
Wait. Mama, what's a prostate?
You need to ask your granddaddy about that.
I sure hope Grandpa gonna be all right, though.
Yeah, me too. He'll be okay. So what you been doing all day?
Nothing. Just chilling. You know, since I'm on punishment and things, ain't a whole lot I can do anyway.
Well, I got a whole lot for you to do this weekend. You can start by emptying all the trash, sweeping and mopping all the floors, and then I want you to get in there and clean that kitchen. And what that means is wash the dishes, dry the dishes,
Wait, hold on, Mom. I don't wash no dishes. Wash the dishes is for girls.
You ate off of them, so you can wash them. Now, you keep on running up on me, telling me what you don't want to do. You gonna be your behind here next weekend, too. Step lightly. Got a headache. Feel like all that noise. Terrell? I said I don't feel like all that noise.
Ouch!
Boy, what's wrong with you?
I smashed my finger. Dang!
Watch your mouth. That's what you get. Got one of them environmental whoopings. I ain't even have to get up. Terrell, get the door.
Man, first I'm the maid, now I'm the butler. Do I gotta do everything around here?
You ain't done nothing yet. Keep on complaining.
Brian.
Hey. missing you.
I'm missing you too, baby.
Wait, whoa. Where you been? And why haven't you returned my phone calls?
Oh, hey, baby. Now, come on. I've been busy.
Getting busy is more like it.
Hey, what's the difference? It's all work. Man got to make his money somehow, right?
Brian, I don't believe you just said that.
Oh, come on, baby. I know I'm just messing with you. You know you always be my number one girl.
Well, I don't want to be your number one girl. Supposed to be your only girl.
Oh, hold on, baby. Where's all this coming from, huh?
Somebody told me they saw you in the grocery store hanging out with that jailbait in the produce section.
Now, that wasn't me, baby. That wasn't it. Besides, look here. Come here now. I need me a woman. I ain't got time for no girl. You know what I'm saying?
You know how daddy do it now. Come on.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you still could have called. I didn't know if something happened to you or what.
I hear you, baby. But, truth be told, baby, something did happen to me.
What?
I fell in love with you all over again, girl.
Yeah.
Woo! Brian, you too much.
I know I am. That's why you love me so much. Listen, baby. Daddy needs you to do him a little favor. Huh?
What is it?
I just need you to front me some cash. But now, baby, come on. Now, that's just until I get paid from all these jobs I've been doing. Now, you know I'm good for it.
Brian, now that's all I have ever done since before you got that job. Now, you still asking me for money.
Baby, I understand all that. But listen here. You do this for me now, I promise I'll never ask you for anything again. Mm-hmm. Now, come on, baby.
That's what you said the last time.
I know.
And the time before that. And the time before.
All right. Now, I hear you, baby. Now, look right here. Now, come on over here. Listen to me. Now, you do this for me, I promise I'll never, ever, ever ask you for anything again. Now, come on now, huh? Who's your go-mans? Come on, Morticia. Come on now. Come on.
Oh. Yeah, well, this better be the last time.
Sure will be the last time.
It's hard to take care of everybody else. Ain't nobody taking care of me.
I understand. I hear you. Matter of fact, baby, I tell you what. As long as we do it like this, you go on back in there and get fine up. And I'm going to take you to dinner tonight. That's how we're going to work that. Absolutely.
Brian, How are you going to take me to dinner? And you just got finished asking me for money.
Oh, whoa. Pump your brakes. Stop the car. And get out. I mean, I'm going to take you to dinner. I said I was going to pay for you anything to eat. I'm just playing with you now, baby. I'm just playing. Now, go on and get all fine for me. Now, go ahead and handle that.
Really,
yeah, there you go. Like a typewriter. Bing, ka-ching, bring it back. Come on now. Yeah. Go on and work it for me. Left, right. You fine, baby. You fine. Yes, be fine. Yes, sir. Sure is fine. Hello? Hey, baby, what's happening? You miss me? Who is this? Oh, okay, I see you trying to mess with a brother, huh? Yeah, I know I haven't called in a while, baby. Listen, I've been busy. Huh? Doing what? I've been busy falling in love with you all over again, girl. Yeah, listen. Now, when you gonna let daddy come by and talk to you? Huh? Yeah, I missed you too, of course. Yes, yeah. Listen, do me a favor. Put on that red, sexy outfit daddy got for you. Oh, you know how I like that. You put that on, girl, we be moving some things. You know what I'm saying? All right, I'll be over there shortly. All right, baby. Bye. Ooh, yeah. They don't make them that stupid no more. Oh, hey, baby, hey. You sneaking up on a brother, scaring me and everything. You know, what's wrong with you?
This is my house. I don't have to sneak.
No, Brian. You shouldn't sneak. You definitely shouldn't sneak in your own house.
Who is she?
I'm sorry, your earrings.
Who is she, Brian?
I'm sorry. Who?
Don't act stupid. Or maybe you ain't acting.
Oh, you're on the phone. Oh, baby girl, that's my mama, you know. Your mama always calling me, checking up. You're looking fine. You ready to go?
Oh.
You're looking good, girl.
That was your mom?
Yeah, mama always calling me and checking, getting jealous.
Okay.
Tripping.
So you told your mama to wear that red,
tight,
sexy outfit?
A little tight.
Twist it, Brian.
Girl, it's hemorrhaging. Look here, baby. Look. Now, I done told you you my number one girl. Now, hey, that ought to be enough.
Well, it ain't enough, Brian. Look, I have been there for you through thick and thin, and you, just like every other man in my life, repay me by cheating on me. You know what? I've been misused, I've been abused, mistreated too long, and I'm done with it. Always been there for you when you didn't have a dime. I cooked for you, I cleaned for you, I gave you all my time. After all I've done for you, you're seeing somebody else. Well, that's alright, I don't need you, I can do better.
No good line.
Look, baby, look, I don't feel like this right now, okay? Won't you just go to your room or something?
All right, Mom. If you want me to leave you alone, then that's exactly what I'll do.
Terrell, wait a minute. I'm sorry. I didn't mean Terrell!
No more, nothing's supposed to hurt.
What you doing here this early in the morning?
I'm sorry, Miss Miller. I thought you were at work.
It's my day off. Now again, what are you doing here so early this morning?
Is Terrell home? I really need to talk to him.
Girl, you know Terrell don't get up this early unless he has to. Probably back there sleeping. Something wrong?
Mm-mm.
All right. You wait right there. I'll go get him. Terrell is not here. His bed is made up, and it don't look as if he came home last night to me. He wasn't with you, was he?
No, ma'am.
What?
Tyrell about it first.
But he's not here, honey. Now, if you need somebody to talk to, I'm listening.
Well, Miss Miller, I really don't know how to say this.
What?
Miss Miller, I'm pregnant and Tyrell is the father.
Woo! Come again!
Pregnant and Tyrell is...
Girl, I heard you the first time! Oh, Lord Jesus! How in the world did this happen? Don't you answer that! What were you all thinking about? That's rhetorical, child. You know, I have talked to Tyrell long and hard about this. How not to let this happen, and he went off and made a mistake like this. Monique, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, okay? This news just blindsided me. I didn't mean to make you cry. Come on, look at me. I should be the one out of all people to understand. Had Terrell when I was you all's age. My mother talked to me long and hard about it, too, and I didn't listen. Because I said, ooh, Terrell's daddy loves me, and we're going to be together. Well, it didn't quite turn out like that. But my mother was there for me up until she died. Have you told your mother yet?
No, ma'am. I haven't told anyone except you. I just took the test this morning. What am I gonna do? I don't know how to take care of no baby. I'm not even grown yet. I'm just a kid myself.
Okay, it's gonna be all right. Just like others was there for me, we're gonna be here for you. Now, you think you need a little more support when you go over there and tell your mother?
Yes, ma'am.
Terrell ought to have his nerve behind here so he can go over there with you. You know where that boy went? Got mad at me and just stormed out of here last night. You want me to go with you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Just wait right here, and I'm gonna go and throw him something, okay? And look, will you please stop calling me ma'am? Because I'm not that old.
Yes, ma'am. I mean, yes, Miss Miller.
Now, that's more like it. Whew. These kids don't believe fat meat greasy till they sliding in it.
Lord, I'm so sorry that I've gone against everything I've been taught. I'm so confused about what to do. Where do I go from here?
Question. Girl, daddy's sick.
Oh, no.
Terrell got mad at me and didn't come home last night. And I broke up with Brian yesterday.
Hey, give me some.
Look, Rachel, I'm going to have to rethink this whole Brian thing. Because now I'm just going to be by myself.
You continue to disappoint me, Tracie. You mean to tell me you'd rather settle for a good for nothing, lying, cheating, begging dog just to say you have a man? Trust me, girl, you did the right thing. I'm glad you finally dropped that zero and it make room for your hero.
Yeah, that's what Terrell said, and I lashed out at him, then he ran out of here. And then to top it off, you know his girlfriend, Monique? She just came by here to tell me she's pregnant and Terrell is the father.
What?
Yes. That's why I'm dressed like this, because I was on my way over to help her tell her mother. But I guess she changed her mind because she ran out of here too.
Sound like we don't need to go shopping, girl. What we need is a drink, and the first round is on me. Let's do that.
Rachel, now you know I don't drink, and you don't need to be doing that either.
Girl, you know this old Christian thing is still new to me. And ain't nobody gave me no handbook or nothing.
Your Bible is your handbook. Why don't you try reading that?
Girl, that Bible is long. You know my Bible got over 900 pages. But even if I read a couple of pages a day, that would take me way too long. Look, what I need is a quick reference guide. From sinner, woo, to saint, and 12 easy steps.
Are you crazy? Ooh, I can always depend on you for at least one chuckle, huh?
Girl, you know God ain't through with me. I am a work in progress. Maybe you have a point, though. I don't need to be drinking first thing in the morning. I'll wait a few minutes. Now, what is it about work in progress that you didn't understand?
Hand it over, Rachel.
Yeah, you keep that. You're gonna need that. You better than me, girl. How do you do it? I would need a drink, an antidepressant, or something. All this mess you got going on.
You know what? Woo! If you're trying to help, you sure are doing a horrible job of it.
Okay. We'll do it your way then. Tell you what. When we get back, we'll call the church and put in a prayer request. The entire church will fast and pray for you, your father Tyrell, and Monique.
Yeah, they will.
Now, can we go to breakfast? I am hungry. Look, now you can sit there and stress out over Brian if you want to, but I am not tripping off of him. I'm ready to get my grub on, girl. I'm not going to sacrifice my voluptuosity. Come on, get your purse and let's go. If you hurry up, we can catch a matinee.
Well, let me go let's check go. On Daddy first, because he's been asleep since we got in here last night. Can you get that phone for me?
Where's your headset?
I don't know.
That's all right. I'll put it on speaker. Speaker. Shalom.
Hey, baby, what's happening? It's me.
Brian, this is Rachel. This is not Tracie. But Tracie busy right now. She can't come to the phone. And from what I hear, she ain't your baby no more.
Rachel, put Tracie on the phone.
Yeah.
Rachel, girl, you know I love Tracie. Now, I wouldn't do nothing to hurt her. Put her on the phone.
You hear that?
Hear what?
What was that?
What?
Click that.
Rachel, who was that on the phone?
Girl, somebody trying to sell you some bull. crap? Can I say that? Mm. Anyway, girl, I told him you were not buying it.
Thank you. You know, we can get ready and go.
Okay, come on.
This boy got this phone all over the house. That's why we can't keep it charged up. All right.
Let's go.
Wait, did I get my keys?
I think so. Did you check? You got everything?
Hello. Yes, this is Miss Miller. Yes, I have a son named Terrell. Can you tell me what this is all about? What? No, I'll be there. Bye.
What?
Oh, Jesus.
What's going on,
girl,
Tracie?
Let's go. We gotta go.
Wait, hold on, girl. I'm driving. Hold on.
Hey, where is everybody? Tracie! Tyrell! Oh, have mercy. I don't believe they just left me here without saying a word. Hungry as I am. Guess if I'm gonna eat something, I'm gonna have to fix it myself. That coffee sure smells good. Yellow. Oh, good morning, boss. I was just getting ready to call you. Well, I'm feeling a little bit under the weather today, and I just thought. Oh, uh-huh. So y'all having a problem with the machinery. So you don't need me today anyway, right? Okay, then. I'll see you tomorrow maybe then. All right, boss man. Thanks for calling. Bye. Ah, good. Use this time to relax and let this pain ease up in my back. Get this paper. Where? Oh, Lord have mercy. I always got to look for the paper. Jesus, Lord have mercy. Oh, I know that kid must don't play no kind of ball because he can't throw a lick. Good grief. What is that? Jesus, Lord have mercy. Oh. What's going on in the world today? Where's my... Oh, Lord, I ain't got time to look for them glasses. Say what? That's right, I got to fix me something to eat. Dagnabbit. That coffee is calling my... What in the world is going on? Am I supposed to be on some kind of fast and somebody forgot to tell me? Who is it?
Hey, baby, how you doing?
Oh, hey, baby sis.
Oh, God bless you.
Well, what you doing here?
Oh, honey, I was going down the street to have a word of prayer with Sister Neely, uh-huh. And I saw your car in front of the house. I thought I'd come over and say hey.
Hey. Well, matter of fact, my boss just called me and gave me the day off. Ain't feeling too good, so it's just as well I stay home.
What'd I tell you about weed?
What? Maybe I stopped that long time ago.
I see you still got it on your mind.
Oh, that paper boy.
Did you go to the doctor?
Well, no, I think I'm just too tired and a little overworked.
J.T. Miller.
Well, actually, I went to the emergency room and they ran some tests and we waiting for the results.
Mm-hmm. Where's Tracie? Tracie!
I don't know where Tracie. I don't know. I got up this morning, the whole house was empty. I guess she left early to run some errands, and Tyrell's left for school already.
Okay, you need anything before I go?
Well, now, as a matter of fact, I could use some coffee and some toast. I can't seem to make it to that kitchen between the phone and the doorbell ringing.
Mm-mm. If you're not feeling well, you need just some oatmeal, something to stick to your bones.
No, I don't eat no oatmeal.
What you mean you don't eat oatmeal? Mama used to make it for us all the time.
Just because she made it don't mean I ate it.
Well, if you didn't eat it, what you do with it?
Why you think our dog Killer was so fat and sick all the time?
You gave the oatmeal to the dog.
Every time Mama turned her back, he ate it right off the floor.
I like Killer.
You know what? I think that's what killed old Killer, too much of Mama's oatmeal.
Okay, well, look here. That's because that was Mama's oatmeal. You ain't had mine. Let me go make you some, okay? I'm going to make you some. Oh, look here. Oh, I love this couch. It's a little low, though.
Oh, baby, my arthritis.
Okay, just hear me out.
No, don't look at me, baby. My back is already hurting. I ain't trying to break it. Mm.
Well, look here. You don't help me up, you ain't getting no breakfast, because, see, I had my breakfast, all right?
All right, okay. Mm. My arthritis.
Oh, it was good. There's something right there.
Oh. Okay, give me a minute. Oh, damn mercy. Here I go. All right. Okay, on three. And one.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three. Oh, Lord have mercy, girl. Feel like you ain't enough oatmeal for the both of us. I'm just kidding, sis. She sit back down on that couch again. Ain't neither one of us gonna be able to get up. Hello. Oh, hey, Doc, how you doing, sir? Oh, I'm fair to meddling. Tracy's not here right now. Well, now I'm a little drowsy, but I can drive. You need to run some more tests? Oh, okay. Hey, by the way, Doc, what did the other test show? Doc, I'm a grown man. You can tell me. What did they show? I see. You want me there at what time? 2:00. See you in a little bit. All right, Bob. Thank you. Bye.
What did it say?
Well, he said they're having a problem with my prostate.
Problem? What kind of problem?
I don't know. He wouldn't say. He just said he want me there at 2:00. They're going to run some more tests.
What?
And he said, I ain't going to be able to drive afterwards. Can you take me?
Oh, baby, I can take you,
Good, good.
See, we may not know what the problem is, but see, God knows.
Yes, he does.
And look here, we're going to pray.
Oh.
And we're going to believe that God going to fix whatever that problem is.
Praise
the
Lord.
Yes, we're going to do it.
Praise
the
Lord.
Yes, y'all, look here. Bam. Come on over here. Help me down, pocket. There we go. Look here.
Oh, Lord.
All right.
Take time. Take time. Okay.
Okay, here we go now. Close your eyes. Father God, I come to you on behalf of my brother. Father, you know better than we know what he's facing.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, we're standing on your word right now.
Yes, Jesus.
That word that says that by your strength,
yes,
we are healed.
Thank you, Lord.
Now, Father, I ask that you would just bless him from the crown of his head.
Yes, sir.
To the soles.
Oh, Lord, yes, Jesus. Jesus, my back, baby.
Lord, you said that if we abide in your word and your word abides in us, we can ask anything.
Anything.
I mean anything.
Anything.
And it shall be done.
Ooh, yes, Lord.
Lord, we ask that you would just intercede on behalf of my brother right now.
Thank you, Jesus.
Father, keep him in perfect peace as he keeps his mind stayed on you. Now, Prostraneous devil, I call you by your proper name because we not friends. I want you to scram.
Shirley.
Scram.
Shirley.
What?
That ain't it.
I'm sorry, pumpkin. Prostromus demonus. There you go. I see you. You're out of here.
Shirley.
In the name of Jesus.
Shirley.
Gone.
Shirley.
What?
That ain't it either.
Well, look here. Point at it so I can lay my hands on it. Look at it.
Point at it?
Oh, that is. Jesus.
Okay, baby. Hold on. Oh, yeah. Hallelujah. Look at here. It's somewhere between the crown of my head and the sole of my feet, so I think you covered it already. We're going to claim healing in the name of Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. Yes, Lord.
Come on in. Just help me up, pumpkin.
Help me up.
All right.
Yeah, oh, Lord.
Oh, there it is. Oh, bow down. Oh. Hallelujah. Oh, we fall down.
Oh, yes.
But we get up. All right, pumpkin, that's it.
Hey, my back feels better.
Oh, hallelujah. He's an all-inclusive Jesus.
Yes, he is. You really know him, don't you?
It's anointed pillar.
Thank you,
sis. Anointed. Oh, it's anointed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Shirley. Do you smell something burning?
Oh, wait a minute, that's my oatmeal.
What?
Come on, help me out.
Trying to burn up my kitchen? Come on here, go on here. Oh,
all right, here it is.
Jesus. Oh, Lord, have mercy, Jesus. Oh, Lord. What can it be, Jesus? Must be something bad he couldn't tell me over the phone. Could be cancer. God, no. No. What have I done, Lord? I mean, I know I wasn't perfect, but I wasn't that bad either. First you took my wife. Had to raise a daughter all by myself. Help her raise her son. Lord, I was sure enough looking forward to retire next year, living my life for me. Now what am I going to have to face? All right, this got to be some good news. Yellow. Tracie? Calm down, baby. I can't understand you. Just... What about Terrell? Slow down. Oh, Lord. No, where are you? Okay, baby. I'm on my way. All right, stay right there. Daddy's on his way. Shirley. Shirley!
What's the matter? What's the matter?
I got to go to the hospital, baby.
What happened?
Tyrell's been shot.
Shot?
Lord have mercy.
Oh, my goodness. Look here. Go get dressed.
Oh,
come
Lord.
On, go get dressed.
Okay, Jesus.
Ooh, I'm going to pray
not
about
my
this.
Grandson, please.
Oh, it's going to be over. Don't play with me, devil. Don't play with me. I got my sword and my arrow. Spot on. It's on, devil. It's on. Hallelujah. Oh, God. Oh, God. Name of Jesus right now. Mm. Jesus.
I don't understand, Lord. I know we're not supposed to question you, but I need some answers. How can this be happening to me? Never thought I would face such a thing as this. I've been faithful through and through, done everything you've asked me to. But there must be something I have missed. Oh Lord, I need the Lord.
Remove this pain from me.
Please take me to my room, please.
Yeah.
And show them the equipment that we had up there.
All right, no problem.
Daddy, I don't know what I'm gonna do. He is just so angry. And I don't know how to help him.
Well, it's gonna take some time now. You got to realize he's still dealing with the fact that it's been 2 months since he's been shot. And we still don't know if he's gonna be able to walk without the aid of a walker or a wheelchair.
Yeah, Daddy, but he's making so much progress. I mean, we didn't even think he was gonna make it at first. Then he couldn't move anything from the neck down. Now it's just his legs.
I know, baby.
You know what the doctor said? If he keeps up with the physical therapy, he might make a full recovery.
Well, baby, now might is a mighty strong word for a teenager that ain't begun to live his life yet.
Got so much to live for. He got his entire future ahead of him. Mm. And Monique is gonna need all the help she can get with that baby.
Yeah, with the baby. With the baby. What baby?
Huh?
What baby?
I'm sorry. With everything that was going on, I just forgot to tell you.
About what?
Okay, you know the day we found out that Terrell was in the hospital?
Uh-huh.
Monique came over here looking for him, and she was visibly upset. So I kept asking her, what's wrong? And finally, she told me that she's pregnant and Terrell is the father.
Oh, Lord, have mercy. Well, now Terrell's taking it awfully well. He ain't said a word.
Because he don't know yet.
He don't know yet. Well, when you plan on telling him? At the baby shower?
No, Daddy, I just told Monique that I thought we should wait because I didn't want him to have to deal with something else while he was trying to get better.
Oh, well. Well, you're right. He shouldn't have had to deal with anything else at that time. Mm-hmm.
Daddy?
Hmm?
What's wrong with you?
Me?
Nothing. Why you got that look on your face?
Okay. Better scoot over. Remember when I told you that the doctor called and said everything was fine with my prostate gland?
Your prostate gland. Prostrate is when you land flat on your face. You know, like when you praying to the Lord.
Well, by the time they get through fiddling with your prostate, you are laying prostrate praying to the Lord. Anyway, baby, doctor said I got prostate cancer.
What?
Daddy,
come on, why did
Tracie,
you tell
Tracie, me? Come on,
baby. Oh, my God.
Calm down.
What are they going to do?
Come on,
has it spread anywhere?
No, calm down now. I didn't tell you because you had enough on your plate trying to deal with Tyrell. And no, it has not spread. Oh. The doctor says since I get my checkups every year that we caught it early. Okay?
Oh, God. Huh?
But I am going to have surgery, though.
When?
Oh, 2 months ago?
2 months ago?
Oh, baby, come on now.
Daddy, what are you doing? Don't you know how important this is if you want to beat this thing? Daddy, you can't just wait around on that surgery.
I didn't want to burden you with anything else, sweetheart. Calm down, okay? Look, when I found out Tyrell was going to be okay, I called and I scheduled the surgery, okay? It's going to be in 2 days.
Oh, God.
I already told Aunt Shirley, and she going to come take me to the hospital, and she going to bring me back.
Wait a minute. You don't think you going over no hospital without me, do you?
Come on, Tracie. Now, you got to take care of Tyrell now. It's only an outpatient surgery. I'm going to be home the very same day.
I'll get somebody here to help take care of Tyrell. You don't worry about that. We gotta concentrate on getting you better.
Yes, baby. I'll be okay, all right? Don't worry about me. God got me, okay? All right. Remember that. I'm going to my room. Take a little nap.
Tyrell think about his new equipment?
Oh, he loved it. He loved it. You know what? I showed him a few exercises he could do when I'm not around.
Good. You know, I really appreciate you helping us bring him home.
It's my pleasure. I had to, I wanted to show him new equipment, everything, and that way he don't even have to try to figure everything out. But I must admit, I do have an ulterior motive.
Oh, yeah? What's that?
Well, you know, I've been seeing you around the hospital a lot, and there's something I've been wanting to ask you, but I didn't have the nerve until now. Tracie, would you like to go out with me sometime?
Mark, you know what? I'm way too busy for a social life right now. And I got a lot of stuff going on.
Hey, listen. If you don't take care of yourself, you won't be any good for anyone else. Look, I'm just saying, okay, you know what? How about breakfast? Maybe lunch? I mean, you still got to eat, right? Okay, I'll tell you what. How about I cook dinner for you? I mean, I'll come over here, cook dinner for you, serve you. That way you ain't even gotta leave the house. Hmm?
know, Mark, that sounds really good.
Well, okay.
I don't know, okay? But thank you for asking.
All right. No pressure. No pressure at all. I tell you what. Why don't you think about it? All right. All right. Bye.
Bye, Mark. Thanks again for helping me with Terrell.
Oh, it's my pleasure. Trust me, it's my pleasure. Bye.
More of this I can take. I'm tired. Tired of thinking. I'm tired of feeling. I'm tired of hurting. Is my life supposed to be this painful all the time? Lord, you saw fit to spare my son. And I say thank you. Can you see fit one more time and spare my daddy too? Can you see?
Wait, what? No, they did, girl. Uh-uh. She did? She didn't. Oh, y'all crazy. Okay, wait, you breaking up. I'm gonna call you back. I'm at Tracie's. I know, but I can't get no good reception up in there. I'll call you back. Okay, girl. Girl, who was that fine brother leaving here? And where you find him at, honey? Let me know so I can go get me one, girl.
Rachel, was you outside watching my house?
No. I was actually coming to see you and Tyrell, and then my phone rang. Ain't anybody thinking about all that, girl? Where you find him at?
I ain't found nothing. It's Tyrell's physical therapist. Mm. Works over at the hospital.
Yeah, well, he can rub me down anytime. Woo!
I said that he's a physical therapist, not a masseur.
Well, whatever he is fine. F-O-Y-I-N-E, fine. What is your problem?
Look, I'm sorry. I shouldn't be taking my frustrations out on you.
Well, if you're frustrated, why you let the massage man leave? Girl, I'm sure he could have worked out each and every one of them frustrations. Oh, work it out, Daddy. Oh, work it out.
Woo. With all this stuff that's going on, that's the last thing I need, another man.
Girl, but wouldn't it be good to have some strong shoulders to lean on, especially in times like these?
Yeah. I thought I had somebody. Guess I was wrong about that. You know, I can't believe Brian. I cannot believe that I spent all those years waiting on him to get himself together so we can get married, and then look what happened. You know the words say a man to find a wife find a good thing.
Exactly. It says a man that finds a wife, not a woman that finds a man and then begs to be his wife.
What?
Hey, I'm just telling it like it is. Look, Tracie, you're a nice girl. You ain't gotta beg no man to marry you. Just be patient. God will send a man to find you. Just because you've had a few Mr. Wrongs. Well, actually, you had more than a few, but who's counting? Look, don't let all of them stop you from finding Mr. Wright.
Yeah. You know, Mark did offer to come over and cook for me sometime. I think I'm gonna take him up on that offer.
Girl, if you don't let that good-looking Nick... gentlemen, come over and cook for you, then I'm gonna get frustrated and need a rub down from your massage man.
I know that's right.
There's that smile. That's the Tracie I know and love. Uh-huh, give me a hug, boo. Told you. Just keep putting God first, girl, like you always tell me. He will take care of you.
Yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome, pumpkin.
She's back.
That's my girl. Okay, now come on and show me this new setup.
Mercy, Jesus. Hold on, I'm coming. Oh, morning, Monique.
Good morning, Mr. Miller. How you doing this morning?
Oh, I'm fair middling.
Excuse me?
I'm fine, baby. Come on in and have a seat. I guess you're here to see Tyrell, huh?
Yeah, he called me from the hospital and told me he was coming home yesterday, but I thought I'd wait and come over today.
Well, now, I don't know if he's up yet, but I'll check and see. Tyrell! Tyrell, you up?
Yeah.
Monique here to see you.
All right, till I be out in a minute.
He'll be here in a minute, baby. Can you excuse me 1 minute, please?
Yellow.
This is JT Miller speaking. Yep. Okay. See you tomorrow morning. Thanks for calling. Goodbye. to.
Mr. Miller, I hope you don't mind me asking, but what does JT stand for?
Well, now, I'll tell you, Monique, JT don't stand for nothing. See, when I was growing up in the South, women had large families, 16, 17, sometimes 20 kids. Well, I figured out they just ran out of names and started using alphabet like A, C, J, T, L, M, N, P. Come here, Q, R, S, T.
Mr. Miller, you are too funny.
Speaking of names, though, you thought of one yet for my great-grandson?
Oh, so I guess you already know, huh?
Mm-hmm.
How do you know it's a boy?
I know a lot of stuff, baby. But I want you to know one thing, that we're going to be here for you. And you don't have to hold your head down, okay? We've all fallen short at times. It's just some of people's shortcomings get a little more obvious than others, but it's going to be all right, baby. Don't you worry about nothing. Okay? You know what? Back in my day, teenage girls got pregnant without being married all the time.
They did?
Oh, yeah. That's where the term shotgun wedding came from. First thing that girl daddy did when he found out was go to that boy's house with a shotgun and made him get married.
Mm-hmm. Well, Tyrell ain't got to worry about that because I don't have a daddy.
Well, now, you may not have a natural father in your life, but you do have a spiritual father. And sweetheart, God ain't turned his back on you or Tyrell because you made a bad decision. And he sure ain't coming after Tyrell with no shotgun. Because you see, my God is loving and he's forgiving. You remember that, huh? Come on, give me a hug.
Thanks, Mr. Miller. Now I feel better about telling Tyrell.
Good, good.
Telling Tyrell what?
Oh, I think I need me a cup of coffee. I'll let you two talk.
Hi, Ty.
Hey, baby. How you doing?
I'm fine.
That's good. I can see that.
Stop it. We really need to talk.
About what?
Well, I've been needing to tell you something for a long time, but I couldn't find the right time.
Well, ain't no better time than now, so what's wrong, baby?
Well, remember when you gave me this promise ring? You said you'd always be here for me, right?
Okay.
Well, I really need you to be here for me right now.
All right, Monique, you ain't told me nothing yet.
I'm pregnant.
What?
I said I'm pregnant.
Oh, I see. So while I've been in the hospital fighting for my life, you've been screwing around with these knuckleheads, huh?
What? You the only knucklehead I've been with.
What?
I mean, I ain't been with nobody else.
I mean, it can't be mine. I can't make no babies right now. Where you been at the last 2 months?
Well, first of all, I'm 3 months pregnant. And I came over the morning you got shot to tell you, but you weren't home, so I told your mother.
My mother? So she knew about this too, and did neither of you bother to tell me?
Well, she didn't think it would be a good idea to tell you back then. So we decided to wait.
I'm glad y'all didn't wait too long. It's still time.
Time for what?
Look, I ain't ready to be nobody's daddy.
And I ain't ready to be nobody's mama either. But ready or not, here it comes.
So what you trying to say? I ain't got no choice in this matter?
I'm telling you, you made your choice 3 months ago when you decided not to use protection.
Well, I didn't know I needed to be protected from you, Monique.
So you think I did this on purpose? I thought your mama told you all about the birds and the bees long time ago.
Oh, yeah, she told me about it. She told me to watch out for them bees, because they'll sting you every time.
What? Wait a minute, hold up! You know what? I don't want to fight. So can we please talk about this calmly? I thought about not having this baby, but all that time we spent praying that God saved your life, how could I just turn around and life of our child.
Look, as far as I'm concerned, there's nothing left to talk about. So why don't you take your baby, and I hope the two of you have a good life together.
Wait a minute, hold up! How dare you turn your back on me? You claim that you hate what your father did to you? He wasn't there for you? So how can you do the same thing?
Look, I ain't nothing like my father.
I can't tell. How can you do the same thing to your son then?
My son? Baby, how you know it's a boy?
Because your grandpa told me.
My grandpa, so he knew about this too.
That's why I be...
Girl, let go of my chair.
Not until we finish talking.
Look, I said I'm done talking to you. So why you still flapping your gums?
You know what? You go right on feeling sorry for yourself.
Okay.
Because I ain't gonna let you or nobody else make me regret the decision of having this baby. When you grow up, call me, because I see right now your words don't mean nothing.
Yeah, whatever. So I guess you got an earful over there.
Couldn't help but as loud as you two were.
And I suppose you got something to comment about all this?
Nope. Not a thing.
Oh. Well, good. I feel like hearing it anyway. Mm-hmm. I mean, who does she think she is, Grandpa? Telling me I'm gonna be a daddy, like it or not.
Your baby mama?
Oh, that was real funny, Grandpa. But this is serious. I mean, what am I supposed to do with a baby? I said, what am I supposed to do with a baby?
Uh-oh.
Grandpa, are you listening to me?
Now, you said you didn't want to hear, so why you keep flapping your gums and asking me questions? Uh-huh. Don't feel so good when you're pouring your heart out and all you're getting is attitude, huh? You never stop to think about what she was going through. Yeah, it's been hard on you these last 2 months, I know. But it's been rough for her too. And you two need to be there for each other. That's what growing up and being a man is all about. Doing the right thing. Now, I just got one more thing to say and I'm through. Going in the hospital tomorrow to have surgery. Doctor say I got prostate cancer.
What? Grandpa, didn't nobody tell me that either.
Well, I'm telling you now. And I need you to promise me that you're gonna step up and take care of your mama for me. Because nothing in this life is guaranteed, son. But life is a God-given gift no matter how short or how long. That's why you need to be there for your child. Go on, think about what I said.
All right, Grandpa. Grandpa?
What?
Can you do me a favor?
What's that?
Please don't leave us.
Go on, boy. You had a full morning. Mercy. I thought you was in your bedroom just afraid to come out.
Why would I be afraid to come out my room?
Well, Monique just left here and told Tyrell about the baby.
Who?
And she told him it was your idea not to tell it yet.
Oh!
I'm sorry, baby.
What did he say?
Well, it wasn't good. Said he didn't want it. Wasn't ready to be no daddy, and she couldn't make him be no daddy.
What?
Mm-hmm.
You think I need to go over there and talk to him?
But baby, I think you need to stay as far away from that house, that part of the house, as you possibly can. You've done enough.
Now, daddy, you think he really that mad?
No, baby, I think he just needs some time to sit down and think things over, that's all.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You say so.
Yeah, I say so.
Oh, daddy.
Hmm.
I met somebody new.
Oh, Lord. Here we go again. Who is it this time?
Oh, it's the massage man. Oh, you don't know that joke. You know, Mark. Terrell's physical therapist.
Oh, well, Hercules, Hercules. At least this one got a job. All right, baby.
Daddy.
Come on in this kitchen. Let's make some food. I'm hungry. Come on. A working man.
Yeah.
You lucked up this time, baby. All right. Tell you, them pain pills sure enough knock out the pain, and me right along with it.
Mm.
Whew. Lord have mercy. Now, what you doing?
I'm setting the table for dinner.
We having company or something? Because you know you don't cook unless it's a special occasion.
Daddy, I cook sometimes. No, we ain't having no company. I just want you to have a good dinner. You know, you can't eat after 12 o'clock tonight. You gotta have that surgery tomorrow.
Yeah, I know all that, but tell me this. Did you clean the cobwebs off the oven before you turn it on? Did you just let them burn up with the heat? I'm just teasing you, gal. But anyway, finish telling me about this young man you see him. What's his name, Narc?
Mark!
Oh, Mark, yeah. Oh, yeah. Terrell's physical therapist.
Mm-hmm.
Well, now he seems like a nice young man. By the time you picked a good one.
Yes, he is.
Tracie.
Huh?
What are you thinking about?
Oh.
I don't think I want to know. That's all right. Keep it to yourself.
You know, he not like that, Daddy.
Mm.
He's a good Christian gentleman.
Oh.
And you know what? He even offered to come over here and sit with Terrell so I can go to the hospital with you tomorrow.
Is that right?
Isn't that sweet?
Look at God.
Brian wouldn't have never done nothing like that.
Hmm. I wouldn't have let Brian stay up in my house by himself. No way.
Why not, Daddy?
Baby, Brian ain't got no job. You never know what he'll do for money. Now, we done had too many things come up missing by letting folks stay up in this house. I don't trust nobody up in here unattended. Now, we done had every DVD player you can think of. Sony, Panasonic, JVC. We even had that one that just said DVD player on it.
I remember
that. That even came up missing. Got a drawer full of DVD books and not one DVD player.
That is true.
Mm-hmm.
But you think Brian's a...
Well, now, I don't know for sure, but I got a sneaking suspicion.
Well, do you mind Mark being here?
No. I just have Tyrell keep an eye on him. So when he moved, Terrell moved, just like that. He moved, Terrell moved, just like that. You didn't think I knew that, did you?
And Mark's not like that anyway.
Hmm.
Not like all those other guys. Well, I think he's really nice.
Well, if he's so nice, then what the problem is?
I I've been hurt so much, Daddy. I'm scared of being hurt again. And I thought love wasn't supposed to hurt anyway.
I don't know who told you that. Baby, love hurts sometimes. I mean, that's one of the ways you know you're in love, because folks you don't care about can't hurt you. But now look, just because love hurt don't mean you have to deny yourself all the joys it can bring. Lord, because when it's real love, it brings a whole lot more joy than pain. You can believe me on that.
I'll get it.
Please do.
Down.
I'm tired of your bells.
Oh. Hey.
Hey. How are you?
You looked in my closet?
No, not at all. How you doing?
You didn't change clothes and cut off.
Yeah.
You were supposed to be here till tomorrow. Something wrong?
No, not at all. Not at all. Mm.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm fixing dinner, so just talk to my daddy so I can check the food.
You what?
Talk to my daddy, and I'm gonna check on the... Come on.
How you doing, Mr. Miller?
Just fine, you. Come on, take
good.
A seat.
All right. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Now, what's your name again? A Clark?
No, sir. That's Mark.
Mark,
yes.
Right.
Yes, mm-hmm. Sir.
Look at here, Mark.
Hmm?
I want to know, what you intend on doing with my daughter?
I beg your pardon?
What do you intend on doing with my daughter?
Oh. Nothing. Mm-hmm. Except treat her like a lady should be treated.
That all sounds nice and everything, but I just want you to know up front that that there, that's my baby girl. And I don't take kindly to nobody doing it wrong. If she say you a nice Christian gentleman, I'm gonna believe her till you prove otherwise. Make her happy, and you all right with me.
Fair enough.
Mm-hmm.
All I ask for is a chance.
Mm-hmm. So now, you staying for dinner?
No. Actually, I just came over here to talk to Tracie for a minute.
Okay, well, look. Have her call me when dinner's ready.
I sure will.
Mm-hmm. Good to meet you, sir.
It's good talking to you as well. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Remember what I said.
Oh, Lord. What my daddy say to you? He ain't trying to run you away, did he?
No, not at all. He just, He actually was just telling me how wonderful you are, but I don't need him to tell me that. You know what? I just wanted to say to you that I am very glad that you changed your mind. Had breakfast with me. I had a good time.
Yeah, me too.
I can't wait to do it again.
I can't wait to do it again either. I mean, have breakfast!
All right. Okay, well, look. Just say the words. Your wish is my command. All right?
Oh, I'm hearing bells already.
Tracie, that's the doorbell, baby.
I know that.
That's...
Who is it?
Hey, baby, open up. It's me.
Brian, I told you we through. Now go away.
Oh, come on, baby. Now you want me to say everything I got to say to you out here in front of all the neighbors?
I don't care what you do.
All right, then. Oh, baby, you remember that time when you and I was out on the beach and you was wearing this little...
Ah! Brian, what do you want?
What's happening, baby? I just came by to, ask you for another chance.
Well, you had your chances.
Yeah, right, but when we was out on the beach...
That's my cue. Look, if you need anything, I mean anything, just call me. I'm gonna check on Tyrell.
Wait a minute, hold up, partner, who are you?
This is Tyrell's physical therapist.
Oh yeah, my bad, I should have known about the white pants. All right, my bad, well, go on and see about your patient, nurse.
Brian!
Anyway, baby, look here. Now, when we was out on the beach, Tracie, and I told you was my only girl and you the only one for me. Now, I meant that. Now, look, Tracie, look, I can't sleep. I can't eat.
Mm-hmm. Kind of hard for you to eat when I ain't there to pay for your food, huh?
Look, baby, it's not about the money.
Whatever.
Tracie, check this out, baby. Look. Tracie, will you marry me?
What I meant?
Come on, baby. I'm ready to do this.
How many Cracker Jack boxes you opened before you found that?
Look, baby, look, only 10. But that's beside the point, baby. I know I messed up. Now, I just, give me another chance. Come on, baby.
Look, Brian, you hurt me, and you hurt me bad, okay?
I know that, baby. Now, look here. Now, I'm telling you right now, I promise. Now, I'll never hurt you again. Now, come on,
Jason. I know you won't. Because you ain't going to be around long enough. Get on up out of my house.
Wait a minute, Mr. Miller, hold on. What'd I do that was so wrong?
Well, it seems a certain pawn shop owner recognized the picture I showed him. Said you frequent his shop with various electronic gifts and such. So now, I got every receipt, every serial number for everything that's come up missing up out of here. So I suggest if you don't want to take up residence in the big house, you leave my house right now.
Believe you. You stole from us?
Tracie, come on now. You know I wouldn't steal from you. No, I love you. I wouldn't do nothing to hurt you.
Just go.
Baby, come on now.
Leave, Brian. Just leave.
Excuse me. Up, excuse me. Clapped up. The lady said leave.
Then I'll go. But you're making a big mistake, Tracie.
You were the mistake, Brian.
Hello? Hey, baby, what's happening? You miss me?
Oh, you all right?
And to think, I was even considering letting him back in my life. How could I be so stupid?
Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Look, look, look. You're not stupid, okay? I mean, we all make mistakes and do things that we regret. Especially when it comes to matters of the heart. But just be glad you realized it before it was too late, okay? I mean, don't be so hard on yourself.
Mark, you know, you're a really nice guy, but I really don't understand how you can stand to be around someone like me.
Oh, whoa. Someone like you. Well, you know, that's an amazing question. But I've got an answer for it, okay? From the first time I saw you walk by, my heart skipped a beat. And I said to myself, there goes a special lady I sure would like to meet. And now that I met you, my every wish has come true. And my life would never be complete till I found someone like you.
Call her, because if I call her, then she'll get the upper hand, and then that makes me look like a punk. So if she want to talk to me, I'm going to wait and see if she called me. Let me just see if she's home at least, so.
Hey, baby. Terrell, enough is enough. Now, I know you can't still be mad at me about what I did. I was looking out for your best interests.
Who gave you the right to decide what's best for me?
Maybe the fact that I'm your mama.
Yeah, whatever.
Boy. You better be glad you're paralyzed. You better be glad you can't move your legs.
Hey, baby, what's the problem? Is your daddy okay? What happened? What's the problem?
It's your great nephew over here.
Yeah?
He's still mad at me for not telling him that Monique is pregnant.
Pregnant? Oh, P-R-E.
I can't believe it. There's someone you told did not tell other than me.
I'm gonna deal with you later. Okay, going to check on Daddy. Maybe you can talk some sense into him, ain't you?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Cause I'm ready to lay.
Oh, I got the hands.
Okay. Yeah.
So you gonna be a daddy, huh? See, I knew I was dreaming about fish. I thought I went to bed hungry.
Look, Auntie, I really don't feel like having this conversation with you, and I'm tired of everybody being in my business anyway.
Oh, wait one cotton picking minute. You roll yourself right back here. First of all, you ain't got no business because you still a kid. Secondly, I don't play with children. So you better remember who you're talking to. Now we're gonna rewind this thing again. So you gonna be a daddy, huh?
Yes, ma'am.
That's more like it. Now, come on over here and tell me what happened. I mean, after the fact that the girl got pregnant, yeah? I mean, did you forget everything we taught you, boy?
I mean, Auntie, I swear that girl got pregnant on purpose. I swear she did.
Oh, wait a minute. I don't know if the girl got pregnant on purpose or not. But with all the modern technology, a woman still needs some help to get pregnant. Now, did you help her?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, all righty then. So why are you so mad at everybody else when you're the one doing the dirty deed? See, that's what's wrong with you, teenage testosterone-ites. See, you want to play a man's game with a child's brain. That's what I tell my youth department because, see, they listen to me because I'm smart. That's what I say. I say you got to look before you leap. Because once you buy the prize, it's yours to keep. And the price ain't always right. Oh, tell them what is one, Johnny. Tell them.
So what do I do now?
Oh, look here. Your life ain't over. You just made a bad choice. Gotta learn from it. And don't go running off trying to get married. Trying to make things right. I mean, you already put the cart before the horse. You know, getting married ain't gonna fix things. We just gotta take things one day at a time. What's wrong with you?
My life is jacked up, Auntie.
No, baby.
I mean, it feel like God's punished me or something.
No. Sometimes things happen just to get our attention. I mean, you know, We took you to church all the time. You know exactly what God expects from us Christians. You just ignored it all. I mean, look at your life. Is God first priority?
No, ma'am.
Well, look here, we need to get that straight first, all right? All right. Bam! Look here, this thing locked. It's locked, right? All right, here I go. Are you ready to accept God in your life?
Yes.
Well, I'll write it in. Here we go. All right, I'm gonna get down. Here. Close your eyes. Repeat after me. Say, God, I'm sorry I strayed away from you.
God, I'm sorry I strayed away from you.
Please forgive me and come into my life once again.
Please forgive me and come into my life once again.
In the name of Jesus, amen.
And in the name of Jesus, amen.
Oh, and I'm done. That's it.
Auntie, is that it?
Well, yeah. I mean, God knows your heart, and if you mean what you say, you ain't got to have a lot of words to impress him.
I sure hope I can do this, Auntie. I don't think I'm strong enough yet.
Oh, honey, yes you are. Look here. You do the best you can, and God will give you the strength you need to endure if you trust him. All right. Listen to me. In your life some rain must fall, but it happens to us all. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning light. Hold your head up, where's your faith? God, it never makes mistake. Though we may not understand, we know it's all in the master plan. The bomb diggity, is that what y'all say? Oh, look here, go, yeah. Say sorry to the mama, say sorry. Get
it. I'm so sorry, mama.
Sorry for everything.
It's beautiful. God is cool.
Oh. Daddy, be careful. But Terrell, anyway, you ain't gonna.
Hey, Mr. Miller. Look who I found wandering around outside, everybody.
Oh, how you doing?
Hey, how you doing?
Monique, what are you doing here?
I got a text message in my phone saying that we needed to talk.
I ain't send no text message.
Well, if you didn't send the text message, who did?
It wasn't me.
Oh, you sound like Brian.
Oh, Lord.
It doesn't matter. I was going to call you anyway. We do need to talk. Mom.
Oh, come on, y'all. Let's let these two talk. Come on.
So, anyway. Excuse me, Auntie.
Huh?
Can we have, like, full privacy, please?
Now look, that's what got y'all in this problem in the first place, all this pride.
Thank you, Auntie.
Thanks, Aunt Charlie.
Let me talk to you over here. I know I said a lot of things out of anger, and I'm sorry. I mean, I know I hurt you, and what I'm asking for right now is for your forgiveness. I mean, I love you, but I'm not gonna lie, I'm scared. I don't know how I'm gonna do it, but I do know I'm gonna be there for the both of you, no matter what. I refuse to turn my back on my child like my father did me. So what I'm asking for right here, right now, is for your forgiveness. And can we just take this one step at a time?
Don't mean that y'all need to keep on ringing that bell. You come with us.
Hey, Shirley's all right. What? Mark could be here any minute. See, there he is right now.
Ooh, girl, I feel a rub down.
Not for my massage, man. Girl, now see, this one is right, and I know it. Yeah, you know what right. I reminds me? I should have thanked you for reminding me that all I needed to do was wait on the Lord.
That's right, girl. Look here, look here. You're gonna be waiting a long time. You don't open the door for the boy.
Yeah, yeah.
Hi. Hey, sweetheart, how are you?
Aunt Shirley, this is Mark. Mm. Mark, this is my Aunt Shirley.
Yeah, it's a pleasure to meet you.
I see good looks running the family.
Yeah, see, he don't just look good. He talks good. You want me to handle this for you?
No.
No, I'm serious. You want me to handle this?
No.
Yeah, you get that because, you know, a good man is hard to find. Oh, that sounds like a play.
You sure are dressed nice for babysitting. You want somewhere else later? Special?
Well, yeah. I always dress nice for a special occasion.
What's so special about sitting with Terrell? I like that, baby.
Actually, something I want to say to you. You remember the other day when I told you that I think that you are so wonderful, so beautiful. On the inside as well as on the outside. And I would love to be able to go to sleep next to you every night. And I would love to be able to wake up with you every morning. And I hope that maybe someday you'll give me that privilege. Because I realized something. Love ain't supposed to hurt. It ain't supposed to make you cry. Tracie, just let me make you feel secure. Let me make you my wife. Tracie, will you marry me? Just say Tracie, will you do me the honor of becoming my wife? Will you marry
me? Yes!
Will you marry me?
Yes.
You remember what I told you?
Yes, sir, I do. All right. Yes, I do.
Welcome to the family, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right.
Oh,
man, come on,
no shame.
Treat my mama well, man.
I will,
brother. All right. Well, now, I tell you. Look like your mama done finally snagged her a good one, sir. And,
unfortunately, it looks that way, right?
Yeah. I want you to know that I'm proud of you, sir, and what you did. Standing up doing the right thing. You've grown up to be a fine young man, and No, I think you're gonna make a great father. I'm proud of both of you. Now, it might get hard sometimes. It might get rough. But don't give up. Okay? Because you have made a new commitment to God. And in God's eyes, your life is just beginning. Just keep trusting it. Hold your head up high. Keep reaching for the sky. Don't let God's blessings pass you by.
Every last one of us.
My name is Regina Carlson, and this is my husband, Tyrone. Pastor, I would like for you to pray for my husband and I.
What is troubling you?
Blessed assurance.
I'm leaving Taiwan. What? Are you crazy?
You know, when I leave, I have nowhere to go.
You don't have to qualify for his love. It don't matter where you live. It don't matter how much money you got in the bank. It don't matter that you got fancy cars and fancy clothes. My God's gonna love you anyway.
Get out of my flower bed. You must be that D-Rock.
Psalm 91. A thousand shall fall, but no harm shall come upon thee. And look at this. This shit is harmful as hell.
You're a crackhead.
Don't call me no crackhead. Okay. Don't call me no okay. crackhead. Look, tell okay. Keisha to come out here right now.
I know, and if you need somebody to talk to, you talk to D-Rock.
Pastor Hearns.
I was wondering if I could join your choir.
Derek!
Am I high? Look at me. Am I high?
And dear God, please look after all those people in my life that I care the most about. And let my parents know that I love them and that I'm gonna come back and do the right thing and they're gonna see me on the straight path. And please, God, look after D-Rock.
It was late afternoon. I was heading back to school. I had my whole life in front of me. Then I woke up.
Cover me, Joe. Where are you going? I gotta go.
Joe, is that you? Where's Steve?
I don't know where he went.
Joe, are you covering for him again?
Aw, Mama. Cut Stevie some slack. He's just young and having fun.
Yeah, just having fun, but I am serious about training.
You know he's gonna make it. He's gonna make it to the Olympics.
Let's do Dead Man's Curve.
I'd visit the chapel down the hall and pray for your son, because he's going to need a miracle or two just to make it through the night.
You just had a major accident. Now it's going to take some time for you to get back to normal.
Look at me. I'll never be normal again.
Lord, I don't think I can do this.
Stevie, you can do anything.
I used to be able to do anything I wanted to.
You still can.
That's easy for you to say. You're not in a chair.
Hey, Joe, where are you going?
I can't stand to see you like this, Laura. How's Stevie doing?
He's never been like this, Daddy.
Kiddo, you really should watch this tape.
Rugby?
I'm gonna play, David.
Life dealt you a crappy hand. Deal with it. The only difference between you and me is your attitude.
What's this?
This, my friend, is hope.
I haven't had this much freedom since before I was injured.
Nice, man.
Thanks, Meemaw.
Welcome.
It's a lot easier taking it from someone that's been down the path before you. Life is different, but it's definitely not over.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch.
We, the jury, in the matter of the state versus David Hamilton in the charge of murder in the first degree.
I don't really think I did it, Grandma.
I just think that the kid did it.
This trial should have been finished in one day.
We disqualified this clown.
How do you stab your own cousin in the neck?
I think the kid did it.
I just want to talk about this. Let's not be so anxious and send the kid off to die.
You know, the case isn't that tough. We all know the kid did it.
This guy's dangerous. He wants to pull the switch himself.
Okay, let's just all go around the table and explain why the kid's guilty.
I know it ain't easy, son. Nobody ever told you it was going to be easy. You just have to put your trust in God and have faith.
My heart is pounding out of my chest. I'm trying to have faith. I don't want to die, Grandma. I don't want to die.
Salute to face, brought forward by his grace. I heard the hate, still I rose and set the pace. Not many can say I survived through the storm, taking the world on from the moment I was born. A testament, I testify, since that was heaven sent. Dollars and cents don't mean a thing if you bent. You catching the hint, many don't.